Ready here. Opening and monologue, take one.
Star Trek will not be presented tonight so that we may bring you the following special program. The following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
The Jack Benny Hour. With his guest star, Philip Dillon. Trini Lopez. Special guest stars, the Smothers Brothers. Featuring the 10 most beautiful girls in the world. Starring the most beautiful man in the world, Jack Benny.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the show. Now, you know, this is the first television show I've done in over a year, see? And I'll tell you how I happened to do it. I had a call not too long ago from General Sarnoff, who is the head of the whole NBC network, you see? You've heard of General Sarnoff, isn't it? And he called me long distance, and quite a while ago, and he said, Jack, call me Jack. You know, I don't even know him too well. And he said, Jack, I wish you would do an hour special television show for me, and how much money do you want? Well, actually, I didn't want to do another television show because I was enjoying my personal appearances. I didn't want any more of television, but I didn't want to hurt his feelings. So, in order to get out of it, you see, in order to get out of it, I told him I would do this hour show, but I wanted $75,000. Thinking, of course, that he would turn it down, you see. And he did. And then he made me a counteroffer on the phone that was so humiliating and embarrassing that I got real angry. And right on the phone, I said to him, look, General. I says, you called me. I didn't call you. I don't need that hour special. I don't need it at all. Now, if you want me to do it, my salary is $75,000. Take it or leave it. And I hung right up in his ear. I was so mad, you know. Then about a week later, when I didn't hear from him. Then I called him. And I told him he was sorry for what he said. And then we made a beautiful deal. Now, I'm not getting the salary that I asked for. See, not near. But to make up for it, he lets me return all the empties from the Dean Martin rehearsals. I wouldn't lose that joke for the world. But anyway, oh, I'm making a fortune out of those empties. But this has been really over a year since I've been on television. And here I am back again. Of course, my being back again may mean nothing to you. But the Mutual Life Insurance Company is thrilled. Of course, I'm not going to tell you how much life insurance I carry, see? But when I go, they go. That gives you a rough idea. Now, getting back to this show, I must say I'm very excited because in addition to having Phyllis Diller, Trini Lopez, and the Smothers Brothers, we're doing something we've never done before. You're all familiar, of course, with beauty pageants. See? I've always wanted to have my own pageant where the girls were picked by experienced people in show business. So we've been selecting beauties from all over the world. And you've had a glimpse of our 10 finalists. We were supposed to have 11, but Georgie Jessel was a member of the committee and he married one of them. Of course, she might be back before the show is over. This could happen, you know. But all in all, I think we did get the 10 most beautiful girls. Excuse me, Mary. Now, later on in the program, as I said, we will be...
Mr. Benny.
I'm talking to people.
Well, this will just take a second. We'd like to get a picture of you with the beauties.
Oh, with me with the beauties? Oh, all right.
This way. Fine,
thank you. Oh, you mean these beauties?
Yeah. Yes, these beauties.
You're the photographer?
Well, what do you think I'm doing under here? Growing mushrooms? Well, don't stand there trying to think of an answer. Just get over in front of one of those now cars.
You mean new cars?
No, he's right, Mr. Benny. They're not just new cars. They're the now cars. They're styled for now. They have engines for now.
Oh, I see.
Suppose we take the picture in front of this luxurious full-size ambassador.
Oh, you mean this one right here?
Get your filthy hands off that car!
I'm sorry.
Well, now there's an ad-lib if I ever heard one.
Oh! I don't know. It's hard to decide which car to photograph you with, Mr. Benny. All of the now cars from the 1967 American Motors are so roomy and beautiful, and they're more powerful than any cars American Motors has ever made.
Are they really that good?
Oh, are they?
Now, cut that out. Maybe I should stand in front of this one here, huh?
Well, that's Rambler American, now available with V8 power.
Yeah, I thought you'd like this one. It's the lowest list price car made in America.
I mean, this is an inexpensive car.
You know, maybe we should take your picture in front of the Rebel. After all, Rebel is a whole new line of excitement machines.
Yeah, well, they're all such wonderful cars. I don't know where.
Well, you're right. You're just going to have to stand in the middle, Mr. Benny.
Oh, I see.
So we can get your picture with all of the now cars from the 1967 American Motors. Now, just give us a big smile.
All right.
Think of this. All American Motors cars have quality built in. Quality built in so the value stays in. That's it. Shoot it, Charlie. Thank you, Mr. Benny. Now you can get back to your show.
You're welcome, Lily.
Would you like a copy for your mantelpiece?
Oh, would I?
Anyway, as I said, we will be judging our beauties from all over the world later in the show. But right now, I want to present to you the singer that these same girls voted their international favorite, Mr. Trini Lopez.
Among the stars, let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, oh darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you. Let me hear you now. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, oh baby, kiss me. One more.
You know, I've heard you many, many times, and naturally, I know you're a good singer. I know you can sing.
Thank you.
But I must say you also play the guitar beautifully. Do you always use it when you sing?
Yes, I do, Mr. Benny. You see, it's nice not to have to depend on anyone else, you know. And by playing the guitar myself, I can provide my own accompaniment.
Oh. You mean when you sing, you always provide your own accompaniment?
Always.
And they call me cheap. Trini, let me see that guitar a minute.
Fine.
You know, everybody plays it. I'd love to play one. I've always wanted to play one.
Well, it's not too easy, you know.
I know. Where do you put it here, huh?
Here we go.
Gee, it's not even easy to hold. Fly me to the moon. And I'll own all the land by June. Trini, how long would it take me to learn to play the guitar as well as I play the violin?
Well, about 20 minutes.
That long, eh?
Well, with a good teacher, maybe.
Oh, quiet. Let me tell you something, Trini. I started to play the violin when I was 7 years old. And if I had kept practicing like I should, do you know what I could have been today?
Treasurer of the Musicians Union?
You know, that's not what I meant, but it isn't a bad idea. Now, take this back and get ready for your encore.
Thank you very much.
You know, it's quite a coincidence having him on the show, because when I was born, my parents thought of calling me Trini. Can you imagine? Trini Kabelski. Well, anyway, right now...
Jack!
What is it, fellas?
Jack, I cannot stand being with those contestants another minute.
Phyllis, you volunteered to be their chaperone.
I can't help it. Those contestants are making me ill. All that dieting, the exercises. Oh, the makeup. Do you know that those girls comb their hair every morning?
No!
What a bobby pin was till I was 26 years old. And that was only because I got locked out of the house. All those girls think about is the way they look.
Well, Phyllis, it's not their fault that they happen to be blessed with a little beauty, you know.
A little beauty? Ho-ho, they don't even wear false eyelashes.
Well, it's too late to change chaperones. You'll have to make the best of it.
Well, all right, but it's just awful. And those girls are just swamped with fellas knocking on their door, calling them all hours of the day and night. And besides, they aren't even allowed to accept dates.
The girls are not allowed to accept dates? Who made that rule?
I did.
Oh, yes, I remember. We did have a deal where you get the overflow.
Yeah, I feel like a motel next to the Hilton.
It was good. First time I heard it.
Well, I went out with a fella the other night. Oh, dear. He wanted to know what place I represented. So I said, "Gets, honey." He said, "Death Valley." Been so insulted in my life.
Oh, you must have been. At rehearsal, instead of Death Valley, she said the farmer's market. She says anything. Listen, I wish you'd go back and get the girls ready for their entrance in their bathing suits.
All right, but there's another thing I want to talk to you about, Jack. I've been watching the rehearsals, and I don't like the way you've got them coming out and parading around.
Well, I thought it was all right.
Oh, Bert Parks would never do it that way.
Look, Bert Parks isn't running this contest. I am. So we'll do it my way.
But, Jack, they're not putting enough into it. When the girls come out and parade around, they should walk like this.
Fellas.
I'm not through yet.
That was some walk of yours, believe me.
Well, it's a lot sexier in a bathing suit.
It would be sexier in a mink coat with the mink still wearing it. Now, look at Phyllis. We're going to do it the way we rehearsed it.
Very well, but you are turning down the walk that made me Miss Hubbard Squash of 1953.
You know, she's crazy, but she's really wonderful. And did you ever see hair like that? Did you ever see a head of hair like that? She looked, to me, she looks like she was pardoned 30 seconds after they pulled the switch. And now, once again, ladies and gentlemen, Trini Lopez.
This train don't carry no gamblers, this train. This train don't carry no gamblers, this train. This train don't carry no gamblers, no crap shooters, no midnight ramblers. This train don't carry no gamblers, this train. This train don't carry no jokers, this train. This train don't carry no jokers, this train. This train don't carry no jokers, phantom women, no cigar smokers. This train don't carry no jokers, this train. This train don't carry my mother, this train. Well, this train don't carry my mother, this train. Well, this train don't carry my mother, my father, my sister, and my brother. This train don't carry my mother, this train. Well, this train. She's bound for glory, this train. Hey! This train, she's bound for glory, this train. Well, this train, she's bound for glory. If you want to go to heaven, well, you gotta be holy. This train, she's bound for glory, this train. Well, this train, she's bound for glory, this train. Ooh, this train, she's bound for glory, this train. This train, she's bound for glory. If you wanna go to heaven, well, you gotta be holy. This train, she's bound for glory. This train.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Yeah, this train. Oh, we gotta move on. If you wanna see glory, you gotta be holy, baby. Talk about this train.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, it's unusual to find a team that's adept at both comedy and music. And it's even more unusual when that team turns out to be brothers. And believe me, for what I'm paying them, they should be Siamese twins. But anyway, here they are, the Smothers Brothers. Well, Boys, I want to say it's a real pleasure to have you on the show.
Well, it's a pleasure being had. What Tommy means, it's a pleasure for us to be on your show. Yes, and I can't tell you what an honor it is to be working with one of my favorite personalities, a man whose artistry is unsurpassed,
Tommy.
A giant in this industry who brings joy and happiness to where he goes. For a man offstage and onstage, living like a giant pillar of excitement and
joy. Now, Tommy, you don't overdo it like
you're
that.
Always putting me down.
I'm not putting
all I try to do is give
now,
a man
don't
a,
get mad at me. I'm
a
just
compliment.
Trying to, I don't care what you're trying to do.
Wait a minute. Look, Tommy, see, what Dick means is you don't have to be so flowery.
Yeah.
You know, about me anyway. You can say what you want without going overboard.
Okay. It's nice to be on your dumb show.
Dick, why don't you mind your own business?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
But you know, I can't get over it. You two are such opposite types. Are you really brothers?
I am. I don't know about it.
I have the strangest feeling I'm talking to Dennis Day.
Well, Mr. Benny, it is. It's true, really. We're brothers.
You are.
And my mom always liked my brother best.
Now, you stop that.
Well, she did. She liked you best, and she never liked me. My mom liked my brother best and never liked me.
You shouldn't say things like that.
You got a bass, and all I got was a little guitar.
Deny that mom didn't like you best.
You wanted to
wait a minute. Wait a minute. Excuse me. I didn't mean to serve it. Now, Tommy, look at you're always saying your mother liked Dick. You're always saying that your mother liked Dick best.
Because it's true. That's why I say it. It is true. My mom liked you best.
Well, wait a minute. How about your father? Did he like Dick best?
Well, no, he didn't like Dick too much.
Well, there you see, it evens it out.
No, it doesn't. He hated me.
Oh, he didn't. He did so. He did not. You act like a fool. You
look, fellas, boys, if I...
Serving it again.
If I want family arguments, I can watch Peyton plays. Oh. Now, how about doing your number?
All right, Mr. Benny.
Okay.
We like to do a song from a Broadway show. The
hey,
show
Dick,
was written
know,
by Lerner
Dick,
and
Lowe. Wait a second. Do you know what the fastest animal in the world is? Thought I'd ask you that. You probably weren't expecting it, were you?
No, I wasn't. Well, I do know what the fastest animal in the world is.
Tell me about the fastest animal
in the
world.
Tom, I don't want to talk about it now. I mean, after.
Tell me what the
All right, it's a cheetah. I went to the zoo the other day, and I saw a cheetah, right? Cheetahs are in all the zoos, and it has a plaque. It says where the cheetah's from and how fast it is. You know how fast it runs? 70 miles an hour. And it said the fastest animal in the world is a cheetah.
Wow.
You didn't think I knew, did you?
That's pretty fast, 70 miles an hour.
Now the song...
Animal running 75...
It's
70,
unheard of.
70 miles an hour, that's pretty fast.
It's unheard of.
But it's not the fastest animal in the world.
It is, too.
There's a faster animal.
What is faster than a cheetah?
It's, a sconce hound. Guess I told you. They run 75 miles an hour.
75 miles an hour?
Sconce hound runs 75 miles
an
hour.
You tell me, a dog can run...
Not That's... all the time. Just occasionally does it run 70.
Oh, just once in a while.
Only when a 70-mile-an-hour cheetah is chasing...
This song is from the Lerner and Lowe show, Paint Your Wagon, and is entitled, I Talk to the Trees. I talk to the trees, and they never listen to me. I talk to the stars, but they never hear me. The breeze hasn't time.
Hasn't time
to stop and hear what I say. I talk to them all in vain.
Stupid song.
What did you say?
Stupid song.
Wait. Don't pick a real nice time to tell me about it.
Well, I wanted to surprise you.
First of all, it's not stupid. Paint Your Wagon is a hit show.
Stupid
and song...
show and a stupid song. Anybody connected with a show or a song like that is stupid.
Did you see the show?
Hmm? It's a dumb show.
Did you see it? Did you see it?
I'm an American. I don't have to see something to know it's stupid.
All right, I agree with you. You're right.
It's right.
A stupid song. It has to be a stupid show. That's... And if the show's stupid, anybody remotely connected with that show is not only stupid, they're double stupid.
They're dumb-dumbs.
Dumb-dumb. I agree with you. By the way, the show happens to be about a young man very much like yourself.
Well, maybe I spoke a little hastily.
The show's about a young man like Tommy. He's young and shy and bashful, but he's very much in love. And, well, he doesn't know how to tell his sweetheart that he loves her, and she knows not of his love. And he longs for the courage to one day to be able to walk up to her and take her by the hand and look deeply into her eyes, say very simply and truthfully, my darling, I love you. I love you very much. And I only hope and pray that one day you may grow to love me just half as much as I love you now.
I will. Will
you shut up? Do that, you see? He didn't have the courage to do that or to tell anybody, did he? But he did a beautiful thing. This young man went out to the countryside where no one could see him and no one could hear him, and he tried to communicate with Mother Nature's wise old trees, and he talked to these trees, and he told the trees of his great love, his new love, his
guy's
first
a weirdo.
Love. And it was... He
went sneaking around where no one can see him and talk. You said he went and he snuck off and talked to the trees.
But that does...
Some weird guy running around in the forest.
Oh, hi there, tree. How's Mrs. Tree and all the little bushes?
Oh. How'd you like your wagon painted,
now,
tree?
I try to... Anything sensitive at all goes over your head. You're a shallow, crass
individual.
Well,
you probably talk to fireplace logs and stuff, huh?
I don't know what you're getting
who's
at.
Who's your fat friend? Used to be a tree, didn't you?
Oh, come on. Of course it was a tree.
Too bad the way things turned out.
See what happens? You hang around
with
the wrong...
Oh, shut up! You think people are impressed with your intelligence?
Wait a minute,
no.
Boys, fellas.
Well, he ruined the whole thing.
I know. Look at it. I don't know what you're arguing about. You were great. Weren't they grateful?
Thank you very much, Mr. Benny.
Thank you, Mr. Benny.
Well, and that's another thing. You don't have to keep calling me Mr. Benny.
Well,
you can call me Trini. I mean Jack.
Well, see, we call you Mr. Benny, both
yes.
My brother and myself, is out of respect.
Out of respect.
After all, you are a little bit older than we are.
That's right.
A little?
Yes,
a little older, huh?
Yeah.
Well, how old would you think I am?
Gee, I don't know.
Well, guess. Go ahead. I mean, I promise you I won't be offended.
Okay.
Just guess. Guess how
Tommy?
Old I am.
He always says
just looking at me, yes.
He always says he's 39, right? So he's got to be at least 44?
Well, at least he couldn't be 44 because he wasn't in the last war, was he?
No, but maybe he was a coward.
Could be something else.
Something else?
Yeah, did you ever notice the way he walks?
You're not supposed to guess about that. Just my age.
Well, we can't figure it out, Mr. Benny. Could you tell us?
Tell you how old I am?
We really, really...
Well, I'm not going to tell you my real age. I'll put it this way. If I were a turtle, I'd be in the prime of life. Now, boys, before I forget, when we do the beauty pageant, you know you two are going to be the judges.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, maybe this isn't such a dumb show after all.
You know what frightens me? In a democracy like ours, it's possible for him to be president.
That's pretty frightening.
That's right, it is.
I'd raise your taxes, too.
All right, I'd raise my taxes. You know Miss Diller, don't you? Phyllis Diller.
Yes, oh, and yes. I can't tell you what a pleasure and honor it is working with one of my favorite personalities.
Tommy.
A man whose artistry is unsurpassed. One of the most beautiful, like a
Tommy,
giant...
Tommy, stop that!
Little flowery, huh?
Never mind. Now, Phyllis, we'll soon be ready for the pageant. How are the girls doing?
Not too good. Miss Sweden and Miss Tunisia are having great difficulty squeezing into those bathing suits.
I don't understand. All the suits are made by the same manufacturer.
I know, but the girls aren't.
Well, look, I don't want the contestants wearing suits that are that tight.
Did you hear that? You must be a lot older than we figured. Yeah.
Never mind. Now, Phyllis, the girls have to be out here in a few minutes, so do the best you can, will you please?
All right, but I still think they should walk like this.
Phyllis, stop!
I don't know, it kind of excites me.
Run along. Go ahead, Phyllis, run along.
Boy, what a dumb show.
This may be a dumb show, but there's something that's real smart. Another one of the now cars from the 1967 American Motors. And now, ladies and gentlemen, while the girls are getting into their bathing suits, I have a surprise that's really going to thrill you. In fact, it's such a surprise, I didn't even advertise it. I didn't want you to know about it. I'm going to introduce one of the outstanding musical groups of the day, whose musical interpretation of popular songs with the use of brass has made them the most popular recording artists. And here they are, Herb Alpert and the Tijuana...
Mr. Benny, please. Just a moment, please, sir.
What? You're kidding. What a disappointment. Ladies and gentlemen, I was about to introduce the Tijuana Brass. You know I was. But unfortunately, they couldn't make it. However, I am told that we have a group here that every bit as good. So, ladies and gentlemen, I will introduce the Tijuana String. And here they are. You are the Tijuana Strings?
Sí.
Then I take it you're all from Tijuana, huh?
Sí.
Am I right in assuming that you are their leader?
Huh? Sí.
What's your name?
Sai.
Sai?
Sí.
The Tijuana Strings, that seems awfully close to the Tijuana Brass. I mean, didn't they ever object to it?
Si.
Well, what do they do?
Su.
Su?
Si.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, go ahead and play something. Now, what are you going to play?
The flea.
I'm afraid to ask this next one. I mean, the flea?
Yes, sir.
Holy smoke. Did you say yes, sir?
Si.
Oh, go ahead and play something, will you? Do you object if I play your second number with you? Well, look, this is my dumb show, and I'm going to do it. Now, we'll start at the count of three.
Three.
C. Now, follow me. And I want to play this real fast. You know, mucho largo. Ready?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, what we've all been waiting for, the final judging of our beauty pageant. And to present the 10 most beautiful girls in the world, we give you our impresario for the evening, the Burt Parks of Beverly Hills, Jack Benny.
Much, please, I appreciate it, but this moment belongs to the girls. Well, isn't this exciting? The final judging to determine which of these charming young ladies will get to wear the crown of this year's Miss Northern and Southern Hemisphere. I don't know about you, but I have a lump in my throat. And now may I present to you our distinguished judges for this event, Mr. Tom and Dick Smothers. And presenting our awards, the equally distinguished Mr. Trini Lopez. And now let's meet our 10 lovely contestants. Here she is, Miss Northern and Southern Hemisphere. Dazzling as my very own smile. Lovely less in each strand of hair. Legs beyond compare. Here she is, Miss Northern and Southern Hemisphere. Scoot. Ruby lips and eyes full of fire. Ooh, gorgeous. Righteousness and wonder will tear your heart asunder, Miss Northern and Southern Hemisphere. Miss Northern and Southern And they are as sweet as they are lovely. Now, first, I'd like to introduce Miss Ingrid Olsen from Sweden. Miss Louise Dupree from Tunisia. Miss Rosita DiCarlos from Argentina. Honey, take it easy. Here, control yourself. You know, with the tension the girls are under, these occasional little outbursts are understandable. Control yourself. Baby, control yourself. Here, just control yourself, honey. Here, here, everything will be all right. Here, just take this. There, a good cry is good for you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, next. We have Miss Catherine Dinopoulos from Greece. Miss Denise Aubert from France. Miss Anna Hoffman from Austria. Miss Weatherly, Miss Marilyn Weatherby from England. I don't know too much about England's economy, but they'll never devalue those pounds. Forgive me for these little asides, but it breaks the tension. Mine. Next, Miss Maria Sanchez from Uruguay.
Isn't that a lovely smile? Are you enjoying yourself?
I am very happy to be here in Long Beach.
No, no, honey. No, no, not. You're not in Long Beach. This is Los Angeles. And next, let's see. Oh, no, Jessel married this one. I mean... that, and I'll... Oh, yes, next, Miss Gretchen Van Dyke from Belgium. And finally, Miss Mitsuo Yamada from Japan. They tell me you got lost downtown this morning. How did you finally get here?
Well, the nicest policeman brought me all the way over here on his little old motorcycle.
Are you really from Japan?
See?
I'm not going through that again. Well, ladies and gentlemen,
there they are. What do you think you're doing? You don't score that way.
Wait a minute.
You score the way I want to score. You had instructions.
Why? What did he do? What's the matter?
He was Go what? Ahead and tell him what you just did. Oh, shame on you.
I gave you 8 points for your walk.
Stop. Just judge like you're supposed to. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I should tell you we already have some honors to announce. A few hours ago, the girls had their own little vote among themselves. And we now ask Mr. Lopez to step forward and present these treasured selections.
To the one voted the most good-natured, Miss Sweeten. To the most cooperative, Miss Tunisia. To Miss Uruguay.
This one I'll give. To Miss Uruguay as the nicest to her parents. Oh. Well, he may have sex appeal, but I've got Medicare. Now, tell me, Miss Uruguay, are your parents with you?
I am very happy to be here in Long Beach.
Forget Long Beach. No, no, honey. I'm talking about your mother. You know, your father and your mother. Your parents. Are your parents here happy? Are they here with you?
I am very happy to be here.
Oh, forget it. You may all step back in line now. You too, Miss Tunisia. Hard to believe she's from an underdeveloped country. Now, girls, as you pass out on your on your way out, as you pass the judge's stand, make your turn so they can get a good look at you. Now, go ahead. Let's have your exit. Miss Greece, I'm telling you, you can't do that. Look, you're not supposed to do that.
Hey, wait a minute. You're going to lose your 8 points.
Miss Greece, that's cheating. Miss Greece, we'll be back with the winners in a minute, but first, a word from our sponsor, the 1967 American Motors.
ladies and gentlemen, we're ready to announce the winners. May I have those ballots, please?
May the best man win.
Our fourth place winner, Ms. Denise Aubert from France. Our third place winner, Ms. Catherine Dinopoulos from Greece.
She cheated. She tried to sway the judges. Now, wait a minute. She didn't sway anybody.
She swayed me. I had her down for first.
Now, our second place winner, Miss Rosita DiCarlo from Argentina. Oh, please, please. She's so emotional. That's because she's so happy.
I'm not happy. I wanted to be first.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the girl who will reign for 1 year as Miss Northern and Southern Hemisphere, our grand winner is...
Wait, Jack, wait!
Phyllis, for heaven's sake.
It's important. I just realized there is nobody in this contest representing the good old USA.
Well, I can't help it. It just worked out that way. Besides, it's too late to get anyone.
It's not too late, and my country is going to be represented if I have to do it myself. This contest is ridiculous.
I'm not going to be in a contest with her.
This whole thing's a farce. I'm not happy to be in Long Beach. Brady Cat.
I quit this dumb contest.
Yes. Me too. Can't stand a little competition.
Mr. Benny, what are we going to do?
Well, what can we do?
It's nature's foremost wonder, this northern and southern hemisphere. This northern and southern
show were Mel Blanc, Ivana Kusslinger, Lenore Stevens, and Coco Tani. This is Bill Baldwin speaking.